Oh, hi. Good to see you. I made that video finally putting to rest the whole Emacs VI debate, and a lot of you saw it, and I got a lot of subscribers. Thing is, I don't want to be the guy who's just ranting into the camera all the time. I started this YouTube channel to do how-to videos on electronics and fixing stuff around the house, important stuff like changing the battery in your electric wine opener. But with Apple releasing macOS Catalina, I thought it might be a good time to take a moment and compare and contrast it with macOS Mojave. Now, I've been a Mac programmer for a long time, so I have some expertise in this area. In the 80s, I did DOS on a Mac add-in cards for the Mac 2 and SE under contract to Apple. And then I worked at the Advanced Technology Group at Apple and worked on AppleTalk and AppleLink and went to work for Global Village. We made fax modems for the early MacBooks. And then finally, I founded a company that did two-factor authentication and Radius servers for the Mac. Of course, this last decade, most of my work's been on iOS development, but I still like the Mac desktop the best, and that's my daily driver that you can see back here. Anyway, macOS Catalina, gee, what a lot of great features. You got the sidecar, finally breaking up iTunes into its individual components, which is long overdue. The new Photos app, voice control. Of course, the OS doesn't run 32-bit apps, but there's a good reason for that. You see, Apple is run by a bunch of incredibly arrogant young fucks making 200K a year who couldn't give a flying fuck if you would actually like to program your old Harmony remote control or use that old copy of Photoshop CS4, because you'll be damned if you're gonna tie to those fucks at Adobe for their overpriced and bloated Creative Cloud. Oh. Or maybe you have to run quick in 2007 once in a while because the reporting in the new version is such a fucking disaster. And what about all those video tools and utilities that read all those old video formats and run all those old capture devices? That shit's never gonna be updated. Jesus! Oh, but you can just run VMware or Parallels. Right, and burn up a crap load of disk space while spending a shitload of time and money setting that up and maintaining it. Yeah, right. Fuck you! Backward compatibility is on you! I don't care that maintaining 32-bit code raises your costs. I don't care that you can't get any young Turks to write a thunking layer for the 32-bit APIs because it's boring and tedious. That's your goddamn job, you sandals with socks wearing shorts and Hawaiian shirt idiot! Ha! Hell, to this day on Windows, if I want to run 32-bit apps, I can. Even 16-bit apps. You know how old that is? All I gotta do is go flip a bit and turn on NTV DVM. Oh, and it's not like this is something complicated or useful, like swapping instruction set architectures. This is just flipping a mode bit on the processor, swapping in some goddamn page tables, and dropping the high bits. So bite me. You storyboard sycophants writing your little Swift apps like the Xcode pussies that you are. Hell, it's bad enough Apple hasn't released a good laptop since the MacBook Pro in 2015. Butterfly keyboard? It's like typing on cement. No MagSafe. Oh, and Touch Bar. Give me a break. Some of us use the goddamn escape key. So now you have to come over and screw up the software too and make life inconvenient for millions of people just so you can ejaculate over some altar of 64-bit conceptual architectural purity and lower your cognitive load. So don't pretend it's for us, the people who pay your goddamn salary. It's all about you, Apple. So, Catalina or Mojave? Mojave, 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 Mojave! Now get out of here!